Eating healthy is expensive, let's be honest. It can be really easy to break the bank when you want to buy the top quality organic ingredients, top shelf supplements, and natural health products. But when you do want to eat healthy and you are on a limited budget, it's about shopping smart. My name is Adrienne Rommel. I'm a holistic nutritionist and women's health coach that specializes in holistic nutrition and wellness for women's sexual health. And in this video, I'm gonna give you my top 10 tips of how to eat healthy while you're on a budget. Like I said before, when you wanna eat healthy but you're on a limited budget, it's really good to start eating and shopping smart. Whether it be at your local grocery store, your local health food store, a bulk food store, or your local farmers market, your buck can go a long way when you get a little creative and have some fun with finding some of the deals that you can take advantage of that will allow you to eat healthy while you're on a budget. Number one is buying seasonal, especially fresh fruits and vegetables, because what you can do is you can buy a lot of them and freeze them, like berries, for example, making sure that you're getting the best fruits and vegetables that are freezable. And what you can do is go to your local farmers market and check out the prices and cost compare between your local farmers market and your local supermarket, because you may be surprised that some of the fruits and vegetables at either one of those places is cheaper than the other. But it does take a little bit of extra time and research, but you can buy these foods cheaper when you buy them seasonal and in bulk, so you can freeze them and store them for later. Number two is buy things when they're on sale. Keep an eye out for flyers and coupons at your favorite stores, whether they be health food stores or your favorite grocery stores or your favorite expensive natural food store. Keep an eye out for sales, especially higher end products like top shelf supplements or natural beauty products or skincare products. These products are usually more expensive, but sometimes they do go on sale. Also, another little hint, you can buy supplements after they've expired, not too long after they've expired, but a lot of stores will offer supplements that have reached their expiry date at a discounted rate. And sometimes you can get the best top shelf supplements at a discounted price, but you wanna make sure that you're taking them pretty soon after their expired date. So keep an eye out for those sales, because they're out there. Number three is buy things in bulk, especially dry ingredients. When you buy larger quantities of these types of ingredients like quinoa and nuts and seeds and rice and any kind of dry grains, you can usually buy more for less, and they're easy to store, they're easy to keep for longer periods of time. And quite often, I know my local bulk food store often has sales. So just keep an eye out for the sales at your local bulk food store and buy these dry ingredients in bulk. And maybe you need to freeze them as well just to keep them fresh, but it is possible to buy more for less at the bulk food store. Tip number four is buying things in wholesale. Big wholesale stores like Costco and even Walmart has big, larger sized items at wholesale prices. So you can get bigger and larger quantities of your favorite products like olive oil, coconut oil, nuts and seeds, and your favorite fruits and vegetables in wholesale sizes and at wholesale prices. And usually they're much cheaper. And it's really great, especially if you're feeding a family or if you've got a couple of people in your home, it's really great to stock up on these wholesale items, because a lot of the time, the healthier foods in wholesale stores are cheaper than buying them in health food stores. Number five, be realistic with how much food you actually need and how much food you actually need to buy. Because you'll notice when you start eating healthier foods like whole grains and fruits and vegetables and meats and eggs and so on, you'll start to notice that you may not need to eat as much food as you thought you did or as you needed to do before if you weren't incorporating these healthy food options in your grocery list. So be mindful of the amount of food you actually need to eat, because when you start eating these healthy foods, especially when you're incorporating protein and good fats into your diet, you may not need to eat as much as you thought you needed to before, which means you don't need to buy as much. Okay, we're halfway through my top 10 list. I'd love to hear from you at this point. If you have any tips or suggestions of how you like to eat healthy on a budget, please leave a comment in the comment space below, because when you share your expertise and information, it helps so many other people who are watching as well. Tip number 6, eating for your constitution. So what does this mean? You might have heard about eating right for your blood type or eating right for your body. We all have different blood types. There's books you can read on this. There's lots of different websites you can find to learn more about what eating right for your blood type means. But of course, you gotta know what your blood type actually is. And it's really interesting because this stuff is actually true. And I know because I'm a holistic nutritionist. You normally do have to find out what your blood type is from your doctor. But if you can find that out, you can start learning more about how you can eat for your specific blood type and which foods work for your body and which foods don't. I feel like everybody needs to do this, but this can help you learn how to eat on a budget when you start to learn more about your body and what works for you, because you may not need those expensive supplements or those expensive foods or those expensive other products that you thought you needed before. When you find out more about what your specific constitution is, you can then navigate more about what to eat and what not to eat that can work better for you and for your body, which can potentially save you money as well. Okay, tip number 7 is asking yourself, what is your relationship like to food? We as women tend to be more emotional and comfort eaters. And there's a lot of people, me included, who like to reach for their favorite treats when they are emotional or when we are premenstrual or when we need something comforting, when we're stressed. As women, we have an interesting relationship to food, more particularly as women, because we go through our monthly cycles and we have our hormones swinging all over the place. So we tend to reach more for the comfort foods when we feel stressed, emotional, getting our periods, etc. So you want to ask yourself, what is your relationship like with those foods? What is it that you want to reach for in those times of comfort or stress or emotional distress even? Are you reaching for expensive foods, like an expensive tub of Häagen-Dazs? Can you replace that with something that's more nutritious and healthy and not as expensive? For example, a pint of Häagen-Dazs ice cream is about $6 to $8, whereas a tub of about the same amount of coconut yogurt is about $4. And although it's not the same, it can still give you that same satisfaction and same consistency as ice cream would, except it's a healthier version. So just making these little tweaks in your diet, being mindful about what it is that you want to reach for and what more nutritious option you can replace it with. For example, do you want to just get takeout some nights because you're tired and you can't be bothered to cook anything and you just want a treat? Is that really necessary, or is there something that you can make at home that's either already pre-prepared or you can just whip up quick, like an omelet and a salad? These are things to consider when you think about your relationship with food, whether it is that you're buying expensive food products or you're eating out a lot. You can kind of change your habits and change your mindset to eat more nutritious, or nutritiously, if that's even a word, by cooking your own meals at home and making healthy substitutions for those indulgent treats that might be a little bit more expensive than the healthier option. Okay, we're on tip number 8, which is intermittent fasting. And I have mixed feelings about intermittent fasting because I feel like for women, it might not be the best option. You just kind of have to try to see if it works for you or not. But intermittent fasting is going between a certain period of time between your meals. So for example, if you eat dinner at 6 p.m. in the evening and you don't eat until 8 a.m. the next morning, your body is going without food for 14 hours. So that technically is intermittent fasting. Intermittent fasting is a big trend right now and everybody's talking about it. I feel like a lot of people are doing it and it works for a lot of people, but for a lot of people it doesn't, especially women, because of our hormones, especially around our cycle. So I don't always recommend intermittent fasting, and it's not about skipping meals. But my point is that intermittent fasting kind of tricks your brain into thinking it doesn't need as much food as you think that you do or that your body thinks that it needs. But in actuality, you still want to be eating consistently 3 meals a day. If you want to learn more about that, take a look at my previous video on blood sugar maintenance because that's very important. But the point here is that if you do intermittent fast, whether it be between 6 p.m. and 8 a.m. the next morning, or you don't eat breakfast until noon, that does trick your body into thinking it doesn't need as much food as your brain might think it needs. So you're not eating as much. But again, the point is here is it's not about skipping meals. You still want to consistently eat 3 meals a day, but you might find that you're not eating as much as you used to. That's my final point. And if you are curious about intermittent fasting, I would definitely suggest to do some research on it before you jump into it, because again, I don't think it's good for some people, but for some people it works. So if you are considering intermittent fasting, just do your research before to find out if it's right for you. Tip number 9 is meal prepping. And this is has been a lifesaver for me, because there are a lot of times where I can't be bothered to cook something after a long day, or I want to treat myself, so I'll go to a restaurant to eat out, or I'll get takeout. But what's nice about meal prepping is that you have already pre-prepared meals in your fridge or your freezer in advance, so that it's A, cheaper because you're cooking for yourself and you're keeping it for a longer period of time. Like, I like to make soups and stews and curries, and I freeze them. I make a bulk amount and then I freeze them so that I have these emergency meals that are already pre-made, that I know exactly what's in these meals. I'm not spending the money going out and dropping a bunch of money on food that I don't even know what's in it. And I'm saving money and I'm eating healthy as well, and I know what's going into my body. So it takes a little bit of time, a little bit of planning, a little extra research and changing your habits. But for example, like, if you're gonna make a salad for lunch, why bother making one when you can make 5 salads and then just storing them in your fridge so you can just grab them and take them during the week when you're going to work or you're working from home and you just need something quick, but you want something healthy. These pre-prepared meals have saved my life so many times, because not only am I still eating healthy, but I'm also saving money while I'm eating healthy. And last but not least, tip number 10 is drink lots of water. I've done another video about this, about why water is important for your vaginal health. But sometimes when you think you might be hungry, your body's actually telling you that it's thirsty. So before you go ahead and reach for that snack, or you reach for that other snack, especially when you're in that afternoon slump, when you're feeling tired and you want something sweet, try to drink a glass of water instead, because maybe it's just you're thirsty. And if you've seen any of my other videos about drinking water is so important for so many things in our bodies, especially as women, and you want to be drinking at least 12 cups of water every single day. The quality of your life is determined by the quality of your health. And remember, it is easy to eat healthy on a budget. It just takes a little bit of extra time, a little bit of planning, and a little bit of research, but it can be done. And the best investment is in you and in your health. And when you can save a little bit of money and still eat really healthy, you can reinvest that money back into yourself for something else. We want you to be the superhuman version of yourself, the bio-optimized woman. If you like this video and you want to see more videos like this, click on the like and subscribe button below and the little bell notification to get notified when I create more videos like this. And let me know how you felt about this video in the comments. And if you have any other healthy eating suggestions or tips that could help other people. Thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.